Everybody, I am Mary Hall Scott, the owner of Permanent Makeup Designs, Permanent Makeup Designs Academy, and Micro PMU Tattoo Supply. And I'm super excited. I want to share this with you. So I want you guys to take a look at my foot. If you remember, I designed a logo with a ribbon and wings for all of my cancer survivors, their friends and family. This was tattooed. I posted this on March 22nd of last month. So you can see how this is fading away. But this is my new design that I'm super, super proud of. So what you do, you guys, is you practice, right? Draw your design out on paper, and then you go to your practice material and practice your design on your practice material, and then you go ahead and tattoo it on your foot. And I want to tell you the story behind this design. So you might see it better on my foot, but notice the dot in the middle of this flower. The reason that we did this design is, I don't know if you guys know this or not, but when we used to treat cancer patients, we would tattoo them, literally tattoo them and put marks on their body, and then we would line the lasers up to those marks. So this individual, this cancer survivor, still has that tattoo on her chest. So instead of me camouflaging it, she had seen my logo and knew that I had done areola art and wanted me to design something specially for her. So that's what that dot is going to be. That's the dot that she has tattooed on her body, and the flower is going to go around that dot. So she's going to have, instead of a dot as a constant reminder, she's going to have something real pretty that she wanted, and it's going to have something a little bit different to look at. So if you guys don't know Jenny Norris Brown, she's fabulous. She's the one that she teaches areola art and got me started doing this. And it's just amazing to change people's lives by turning a dot into a flower. It means so much to them. So all you guys, to practice things like this, I want to show you something that my student sent me. And her homework was to do dots. And you can see she started out doing a lot of dots and she got bored. So then she created eyebrows, eyes. She put her name in here, did a man's face. I'm not quite sure what this is. But the whole point of this, you guys, is to step outside of your box and have some fun. So I get people calling, emailing me, texting me all the time, and they're really frustrated because they can't make a brow look a certain way, or they can't make an eyeliner look a certain way. And what I want you guys to think about is just practicing on paper, practicing on practice material, practice on your feet, but step outside of your box, start to do designs, add colors, start to be creative, and let some of those juices flow and take away some of those frustrations. So that's it for now. I just wanted to share my second design with you guys. So see you soon. Thanks. Bye.